the exhibition, the show that we're putting on here at the Smithsonian on human origins, is an idea that goes back, in my mind, at least 20 years. The vision of presenting to the public the artifacts and, of course, the fossil evidence of how we became human was just very important to me when I joined the Smithsonian as a member of staff more than 20 years ago. But it takes more than one person's vision. It takes a whole group of people to put an exhibit together, designers and people who can write the script. And most of all, it includes a lot of partners, international partners, who are able to make available to us part of the natural heritage of their countries, the fossils and the stone tools. And of course, when those objects cannot leave those countries because we have a long-term exhibit here, they are able to provide to us the exact replicas of those objects. So what our exhibit does is that it does something that no other exhibit in the world does. It's not just about the discovery of a particular fossil human. It's not just about the debates that rage in scientific circles about our family tree and who was related to whom of the early species of fossil humans. Rather, it's about the emergence of human characteristics, the things that define every single human being on Earth today. And it allows people the chance to explore the antiquity of walking upright on two legs, when we started making tools and the changes in technology over time, when our brains became large, the origins of art and our ability to use symbols and language. And so it allows the visitor to explore that deep antiquity and to see that everything didn't happen all at once, but rather things occurred over a 6 million year period in accumulating the characteristics of what it means to be a human being today. In addition to that, we have a very important theme of climate change, of how early humans were responding to the dynamic environments of Earth's climate history over the past 6 million years. And so this idea of bringing these two vibrant areas of scientific discovery, paleo climate change, ancient climate change, and human origins, is, I think, a really fascinating way, a new way to present the subject to our public.